What is the difference between business analyst and a data analyst? A very common question which is asked to me, to everyone, time and again. And with my understanding, I will try to dissect the subtle differences between these two roles, because these two roles are so closely linked to each other that sometimes the difference is very, very thin. So the very first difference is something I have taken from the internet, and although I'm not totally in agreement with this, but this gives you an insight as to what is the difference here. So a business analyst takes data and starts his or her journey to draw business insights, and then to enable taking business decisions based on the data he or she has got. Whereas a data analyst journey ends pretty much at the point where he or she comes up with that story, that compelling story, using data analytics or data insights. However, I would like to add that at certain places, the journey does not stop here for a data analyst, and the data analyst goes on to work closely with business and help them take those business decisions. And that's the reason why we get confused, because the line is so thin that you don't know that when you cross that line from being a data analyst to a business analyst. But as we go along, we'll be more clearer as to what is expected from each role. So friends, before we move ahead, let me answer a very common question asked by you all, and that is, sir, how I should start my career in data, how I should become a data analyst, how I should revamp my career in the data industry. Well, today I have the answer, and the answer is Google Data Analytics Professional Certificate, a fantastic program curated by the employees of Google and offered on Coursera, as you all know, world's top class learning platform. This particular program is a 6 months program that requires no prior experience. So you might be coming from the data industry, you might not be coming from the data industry or IT industry, does not matter. This 6 months program has been specially curated to put you on to that journey to become a data analyst. So this particular program has 8 different courses, and these 8 courses, as I said, has been specially curated by Google employees who themselves started their journey in Google or in their own career as data analyst. This particular course so far has been enrolled by 1.2 million students, and more than 93,000 students have given 4.8 star rating out of 5. So you could understand the quality of this particular program. But most importantly, what you would learn in this particular program. So you would learn, you know, the day-to-day job of a data analyst. You would learn what a data analyst do in his job. You would understand what kind of data analysis you need in order to do a role of data analyst. It starts by data, analyzing the data, cleaning the data, you know, representing the data into different visualization platforms like Tableau. All those kind of tasks which a data analyst does will be taught to you as a part of this program. You would learn how to clean and organize the data using spreadsheet, using R, using languages like SQL, and eventually you would showcase all that data into a dashboard using platforms like Tableau. And if you could give 10 hours per week, you could finish this program in less than 6 months. Best part is you get a professional certificate after completing this program successfully, which you could put in your CVs and resumes and on your LinkedIn profile to attract potential employers. So I think you should definitely explore this particular opportunity. And if you want to, you could do it for free. Go in the description box, click on the affiliate link, and you would get a free 7-day trial of this particular program. I sincerely hope this program helps you get into the data industry. Now let's continue with our video. So the second and the most important is coding knowledge. If you want to become a business analyst, coding knowledge is good to have, but not a must have. If you have it, it's always an edge regardless of which post you're working in, which role you're working in. But to be honest, you are not needed to have this. You only need the business domain knowledge, which is required and which we'll talk about. But when it comes to data analyst, coding is a must. You need to know languages like R or Python. You need to work on libraries like Panda, which is a famous library for data manipulation in Python. So yes, coding is a must. The third is what is expected from you as a business analyst. So the expectation is you would evaluate and improve business processes, and then you will share business insights, and eventually you will understand and deliver the new business strategy to improve the business. This is more on the business side of things. While the backbone of all this would be data, but then this would be the end product for a business analyst. On the data analyst side, you are needed to work on data systems. You need to build reports, you need to clean the data, extract the data, and then you have to work on BI reports, for example, to build insights, data insights, not business insights. There's a difference. So data insights would be needed by the business stakeholders, which would eventually help them take an informed decision. So it could also happen that you being a data analyst might create this report for your business analyst. So that can also happen. So coming on the tool side, I think business analysts only need to know Excel, MySQL, basic SQL knowledge is sufficient for business analyst to do his or her job. But on the data analyst side, you need wide range of tools because you are working for different kinds of data. You need database knowledge, you need Python, R, you also need BI report, Power BI, business intelligence products. You need to have hands-on on that. And most importantly, you need to now also learn cloud, because all these data analysis which you will do will eventually connect to a cloud platform. So you need to have a wide variety of technical expertise on these different technologies, data technologies. And then on top of that, if you could demonstrate some domain skills, then it's a plus plus. So that is our fifth difference, that business analyst needs domain knowledge. And that's why a lot of MBA graduates go into business analyst roles, because they know the domain, the business domain, way better than a technical role or a technical data analyst guy. For a data analyst, they need primarily, they look for a data skills, which we have discussed in detail. Plus, if they have the domain knowledge, it's a great advantage, because eventually, even with data, you need to know the domain to a certain level. So yes, and then you could always have a Bachelor of Engineering or BTech degree. Sometime people from BSc, BA backgrounds as well, Master of Computer Science background, a lot of different backgrounds could come and join as a data analyst. Career progression, the very clear career progression is a business analyst can go into a data analyst role and then follow a completely data related career. Or then maybe they could detour and take a different route to a business relationship manager or a functional consultant, because they always have that business domain knowledge. But it's up to them. If a guy is more inclined towards the functional or the business aspect of an industry, then they should rather take those kind of roles. But if he wants to explore more on the technical side, because obviously the demand is higher, the salary package is higher, then they can take the data analyst route as well. Whereas in here, very clear path: data analyst, data engineer, data scientist, artificial intelligence or ML engineer as well. There are so many roles. Data analyst is just the entry point. And if you could do well, if you know one language, one programming language and one ETL tool, and then you know data warehousing concepts, you know data science concept, or if you learn it on a project, then this could be a very great career progression for a data analyst. So coming to the most important and discussed part, which is the salary, I'm not putting any numbers here because numbers could change and then it changes through geographies and all. So I'm not putting a number, but generally business analysts tend to have a lower compensation or salary compared to data analysts at this point of time. Because for example, if a business analyst is just taking an entry position without having a business domain knowledge, then that does not work in their favor. Whereas for a data analyst role, the kind of the variety of things which a data analyst could do is way more than a business analyst, especially in today's generation, today's era. And then data analyst could very well become a business analyst or play a part-time business analyst role if they already have domain knowledge. So whatever I see, I could be wrong because these figures I have also taken from internet, but data analyst wins this comparison as far as the salary structure is concerned. But there is a caveat here. Suppose you worked in IT industry or any manufacturing industry, for example, for 10 years, and then you go to a grade B plus school, MBA school, do your MBA degree, come and go for an interview for a business analyst, then the table would turn, because you already have the knowledge which is needed for entering into a higher role with higher package as a business analyst. So that's the caveat. So guys, I hope after watching this video, now you have some idea of where the line is when it comes to a data analyst role versus a business analyst role, and which role is suitable for your career. So if you have any doubts, please feel free to mail me, please feel free to comment on this particular video. And if you want me to make such videos on different kinds of IT roles where you get confused, please let me know that as well in the comment section. So until next time guys, keep learning, keep sharing all your knowledge, and yes, keep hustling. Bye for now.